So welcome everyone in today's session, we are talking about regression analysis. In the previous video, we talked about why we do regression analysis. Now we'll be doing regression analysis in R. So first of all, to do regression analysis, the command is lm.lmprice. So if you need to do remember what is LM, LM is linear model. So linear regression is LM. So if you go, if you write in help LM, it will give you all the documentation, how to run it, and what are the requirements, what are the codes, and then there is an example. So in this example, you can see the regression has been estimated. So this way you can understand. So here, we need to run this regression. So the command is fit is the output of the regression, and it is regression line fitting. LM is the linear model. Price is dependent variable, and there is a curly sign which is usually on the below the escape. So price, curly, MPG plus displacement. Okay, so there are two independent variables, miles per gallon and displacement, and comma data is equal to auto. So it means we will do the fit, means we will calculate the regression estimates using linear model, means linear OLS model, the simplest possible regression. And the dependent variable is price. Independent variable are MPG plus displacement, MPG and displacement. And the data file we are selecting is auto. So when I run this, execute, so it will calculate the estimates and store and fit. So if you want to see the output, we'll press summary dot bracket fit. So it will summarize the results of the regression. If I execute it, it will show me the regression results. So if I go bring it up, so you can see call command is the linear model and this command. So first of all, it will give me some diagnostic of residuals. So you can see it here, the residuals median value is -670.6. So ideally, theoretically the mean value is zero, but the median value is not zero. It means the error terms have some problem. We'll look at it later. And now we'll go towards coefficients. So we already understood the interpretation in the previous activities. Now we look at that here, the MPG variable is negative. So it means if the car is consuming higher fuel, its miles per gallon is higher, means the car is more efficient. So it is telling us that if it is it runs more miles per gallon, it means it is more fuel efficient. The price is low. It means if car is 1 mile per gallon higher, means if it is running one extra mile per gallon, the price is $121 smaller. So for one reason can be that in the data we didn't include the variable of car size. So it means the smaller cars which are more fuel efficient and which are also cheaper. So the model is picking that relationship. So which are fuel efficient? The fuel efficient cars usually have high lower price. So it's a negative coefficient. But the T value is less than -1.96. It should be between 1.96 and -1.96. So from the p-value, we can see that the p-value is greater than 0.05. So it means at 5% level, this variable is insignificant. So it means in our example, prices are the miles per gallon variable is not able to explain the past behavior of the miles per gallon. So we cannot predict the past data of miles per gallon just because of the changes in the past data of prices, just because of changes in the miles per gallon. Another variable is displacement. How much speed it picks up. So if displacement increases, the price increases. It means the more powerful car is, the more speed that it picks up faster, the more the pricey it is. So the powerful car or the acceleration is higher, the cost of the price is cost of the car is also higher. And looking at the p-value, it is less than 0.05. It means this actor or this indicator is significantly explaining the differences in the price of the car in the past. So it means we have one variable that explains. So then we have R squared and it is 0.27. It means our two variables that we proposed are successfully able to explain 27% of changes in the price of the car. And adjusted R is 25.29. It is 25.2%. We'll discuss it later. What is the difference between R and adjusted R? And then the F statistics. F statistics compare the overall performance of the model. So the p-value of statistics is very small. So if I write it in standard notation, what does it mean? So if I write it here, so 1.95 minus 0.05 is actually 0.12345, 1.1195. So it is very small. So it is less than 0.05. So overall model is fit. It means our two indicators that we proposed are jointly successfully explaining the past behavior of differences in the sale price of vintage cars. So this way we understand how to run a regression and how to report it. So that we come to conclude that this is a regression model.